Dear students, a warm welcome to this channel. In this video, we are going to see how to draw the graph of a cosine function and its inverse. First, let us see how to draw the graph of a cosine function. So for that, let us take angles for x and its corresponding cosine value for y. Okay? So let us take 0, pi by 3, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 5 pi by 2, 3 pi, such angles for x, and then let us write down, find out the corresponding cosine value for that. So when x is equal to 0, cos 0 will be 1, and when x is pi by 3, that is 60, cos 60 is 1 by 2, then when x is pi by 2, cos 90 is 0, then when x is pi, cos pi is minus 1, then when x is 3 pi by 2, that is cos 270 is 0, again cos 2 pi will be 1. Then cos 5 pi by 2 will be again 0, and then cos 3 pi will be minus 1. Like that, you have to take down the values of x and the corresponding values of y. Let us take down the angles along the x-axis and the corresponding values along the y-axis. See here, the maximum and minimum value of cosine function is plus 1 and minus 1, and the values will lie between plus 1 and minus 1. So we have taken minus 1 and plus 1 along y-axis and the angles along the x-axis. Okay. Then for x and the value is y, so let us plot this point as 1, 0, 1, okay. And then pi by 3, 1 by 2. So for pi by 3 somewhere here and 1 by 2 here, the point is marked here. And then for pi by 2, the value of y is 0 and it is marked here. And then for pi, the value of y is minus 1. So for pi, the value of minus 1, so the point is has been plotted here. And for 3 pi by 2, y is 0, so we have taken this point. And then for 2 pi, the value of y is 1, so I have taken the point here. Then for pi, pi by 2, the value of y is 0, again this would be, the point is marked here. And for 3 pi, the value is minus 1, so let us mark this point here. Likewise, it will go, okay. And then for the negative x-axis, for cos of minus pi by 2 and cos pi by 2 will be same. So cos of minus pi by 2 is also equal to 0. And then cos of minus pi and cos pi will be equal, and therefore that will be also equal to minus 1. So likewise, we let us take down the values, corresponding values, and we plot the points. If we join all these points by a smooth curve, you will get the cosine graph. Okay, so this is the shape of the cosine graph, and then which does not pass through the origin, right? It passes through, the maximum value is 1 and the minimum value is minus 1. So this is the cosine graph. Now let us see what is the amplitude and what is the period of this cosine graph. You know that amplitude is nothing but the distance measured from x-axis to its maximum or to its minimum. So if we measure the distance from x-axis to its maximum, this is nothing but 1 unit. Likewise, if you measure the distance from x-axis to the minimum, it is also equal to 1 unit. So amplitude of this cosine graph is 1 unit. Okay. And then what is meant by period? Period is the distance along the x-axis taken for one complete revolution, or the distance between two crests, or the distance between two trough. Okay, so these are called a trough, and these are called the maximum points are called the crest, and that is crest, and here the minimum point is called a trough. So the distance between two trough, or the distance between two crest, or we can take the distance for one complete revolution as a period, right? So the distance taken for one complete revolution, that is 0 to 2 pi. Therefore, that is period is 2 pi. Or look at here, the distance between two crest is also 2 pi. That is each unit is pi by 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4 units of pi by 2 is equal to 2 pi. So even you can look at that, the distance between two trough, again, how many units? 1, 2, 3, 4, each one is pi by 2. So that is 4 into pi by 2, again it is equal to 2 pi. So the period is 2 pi. Okay. Now what are the properties we can observe from the cosine graph means? Look at the graph, or the graph is never had any break. So it is together, continuous together, right? Therefore, we can see that as the graph has no break at all, we can conclude that the cosine graph is a continuous function, okay? Then, as the graph is symmetric about y-axis, the portion to the right of y-axis and the left of y-axis are similar. That means they are symmetric about y-axis. As the graph is symmetric about y-axis, we can say that the function is an even function. So, a function is even means its graph will be symmetric about y-axis. If a function is odd, its graph will be symmetric about origin. So sine is a odd function and its graph is symmetric about origin. But cosine is an even function, so its graph is symmetric about y-axis. Okay. And what is the maximum value? Maximum value is 1 and the minimum value is -1. And the maximum value 1 is obtained at 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, minus 2 pi, etc. And the minimum value is obtained at pi, 3 pi, minus pi, etc. Okay. Now, one more property is also true by the graph. You can also see one more property is also true obtained by the graph. Now, look at this. Here, I have drawn both the cosine graph and the sine graph. This one represents the sine graph which passes through the origin. And this is the cos graph. Okay. Now, if you see that, if we move the cosine graph pi by 2 units right side, it will overlap the sine graph. That is, if we shift the graph cos x, y is equal to cos x, to pi by 2 radians to the right side, then it will overlap the sine graph, y is equal to sine x. That is, in short, we can say that cos of x minus pi by 2, that is moving pi by 2 to right side, so x minus pi by 2, then what happens to this equation? That will be equal to sin x. This graph is equal to sin x graph. So cos of x minus pi by 2 is equal to sin x. Now if you take one minus outside, it will be cos of minus of pi by 2 minus x, but cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta, so it can be rewritten as cos of pi by 2 minus x, that is equal to sin x. So this is true, we know that. So this condition, this property is also true by the graph. So we can see that this is also true by looking at the graph. Now let us see the inverse cosine function. Okay, you know that inverse function is possible only the function is a 1-1 function. But cosine function is not 1-1 function in the entire domain R. Why? Let us see that. Okay, now come to this. These are the four quadrants where all angles are positive. Here all ratios are positive. Here sine ratio is positive. Here tan is positive and here cosine is positive. Okay. Now you know that cos of minus x is also equal to cos x. That means minus x means the angles in the fourth quadrant and the cos x lies in the first quadrant. Therefore the angles in the first quadrant and the second quadrant would be same. Right. The cosine value would be same. For angles in the first quadrant and the fourth quadrant, their cosine values would be same. Then cos of pi minus x is also equal to minus cos x. Cos of pi plus x is also equal to minus cos x. That means that cos of pi minus x and cos of pi plus x are equal. Pi minus x means where the angle lies, it lies in the second quadrant. Pi plus x means that angle lies in the third quadrant. So for the angles lie in the second and third, the cosine values would be equal. You can see by an example. See cos 150 degree. 150 degree lies in the second quadrant. Okay. Cos of 180, it can be written as cos of 180 minus 30. That is pi minus 30. That is nothing but cos of pi minus 30. As the sine is positive and cos is negative, it will be equal to minus cos 30. That is minus root 3 by 2. Now let us take 210, an angle in the third quadrant. So let us find its cos value. Cos 210 is equal to cos of 180 plus 30, that is pi plus x here. So again in this third quadrant also cosine is negative, so it will minus cos 30, that is minus root 3 by 2. Therefore cos 150 degree and cos 210 are equal, right? Therefore the four angles in the third quadrant and the second quadrant, their cosine values will be equal. And the four angles in the first and the fourth, the cosine values will be equal. Therefore we cannot define an inverse function as the cosine function is not 1-1 because the values gets repeated. So how to define an inverse function? If we restrict the domain to be such that no values get repeated, then only we can define an inverse function. So let us choose these two quadrants so that the values of the cosine does not get repeated. So if you choose these two quadrants, that is from angle 0 to pi, then in that domain cosine function is 1-1, that is no value get repeated. For that domain we can define an inverse function. Okay. So if the domain, unless the domain is restricted, the inverse function of cosine is not defined. So if the domain is restricted, the cosine inverse cosine is possible. Therefore what is the domain for the inverse function to exist? Let us take the angles in the first and the second, that is the domain should be closed interval 0 to pi. Okay. So in this, if we take the domain of the cosine function as the closed interval 0 to pi, then we can define the inverse function. Do you understand that? Now let us define the inverse cosine function as, if cosine function is from the closed interval 0 to pi to the range, the closed interval minus 1 comma 1, then the inverse cosine function is defined as cos inverse of from the closed interval minus 1 to 1 to the closed interval 0 to pi, where cos inverse of x is equal to y if and only if cos y is equal to x, right? Where x belongs to this closed interval minus 1 comma 1 and y belongs to the closed interval 0 comma pi, right? This is the definition of inverse cosine function. So inverse cosine function is defined only if the domain of cos function is 0 to pi, closed interval 0 to pi. Inverse function means these two gets reversed, and then cos inverse of x is equal to y means cos y is equal to x, where x lies to the domain minus 1 comma 1 and y belongs to the range 0 to pi, closed interval 0 to pi. Okay. Even we can have some other domains, okay? So look, even you can see that these two, the angles in these two quadrants, the cosine values don't get repeated. So even you can take the domain as from pi to 2 pi. Likewise, after one complete revolution, even again you can take the first two quadrants as 2 pi to 3 pi, again 3 pi to 4 pi. Like that, we can also change the domain as, okay? We can also change the domain as pi to 2 pi, 2 pi to 3 pi, 3 pi to 4 pi in the anti-clockwise direction, and in the clockwise direction 0 to minus pi, minus pi to 2 pi, like that. So even in this domain also the cosine function is 1 1, and also we can define the inverse cosine. Okay. So the other restricted domains are closed interval pi to 2 pi, 2 pi to 3 pi, etc., and from minus pi to 0, like etc. Then among this the closed interval 0 to pi is called the principal domain. Okay, this is called the principal domain, and the corresponding values of y belongs to this principal domain, such that cos inverse of x is equal to y, are called the principal values. So the corresponding values of y belonging to the domain are called the principal values of the inverse cosine function, and this is the principal domain of the cosine function. Okay, this is the principal domain of the cosine function, and some two results are here. Cos of cos inverse of x is also equal to x. Okay, cos of cos inverse, because they are reversed to each other, cos of cos inverse of x is equal to x. And what would be the range of x? X lies between minus 1 to plus 1. That is, modulus of x less than or equal to 1. So x should not exceed 1 or go below minus 1. Therefore, they have written that no sense if modulus of x is greater than 1. So this is nothing but x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. Again, cos inverse of cos x, that is also equal to x. And what would be the value of x? X lies between 0 to pi. Here the range of x is 0 to pi. So y here it refers angle, and here value means, here cos inverse of x means here x takes some values, not angle. It doesn't represent angle, it represents a value. So that value lies between minus 1 to 1. Here x refers to angle, so angle should lies between the domain 0 to pi. So remember, cos of cos inverse of x is equal to x only if modulus of x is less than or equal to 1, that is x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. And cos inverse of cos x is equal to x only if x lies between 0 to pi, that is x belongs to the closed interval 0 to pi. Now let us see a small example. If that x is doesn't belongs to 0 to pi means how to find its value, right? So consider this example, cos inverse of cos of 3 pi. You know, 3 pi doesn't belong to the principal domain 0 to pi. So, in order how to find, evaluate this, if the angle is doesn't belongs to the principal domain means, what you have to do, you have to split this, and you have to make this angle to be equal to an angle which lies in the domain, principal domain 0 to pi. Okay. So, you have to rewrite this as an angle which belongs to the closed interval 0 to pi, that is in the principal domain. So, how can we write 3 pi? We can split 3 pi as 2 pi plus pi. Cos of 2 pi plus pi is nothing but cos pi, right? So cos inverse of, now pi belongs to the closed interval 0 to the closed interval 0 to pi, that is the principal domain. So cos inverse of cos pi is equal to pi. So when the angle doesn't belong to the principal domain means, you have to rewrite this angle as another angle which lies in the principal domain, okay, whose values would be same.
and then you have to use the formula cos inverse of cos x is equal to x.
Now let us see the graph of the inverse cosine function. Okay, so for that let x takes the value -1, 0, 1. For these three values let us find the corresponding angles. Y is equal to cos inverse of x. For if x is -1, the angle would be pi, and for if x is equal to 0, the angle would be pi/2, and x is equal to 1, the angle would be 0. Okay, so taking these points, that is plotting the value -1, 0, 1 along the x axis, and 0, pi/2, pi/3, pi/2 the angles along the y axis. And if you take the point -1, pi, and 0 to pi/2, 0, pi/2 as a point here, and 1, 0, and if you join this, you will get the graph of the inverse cosine function for the domain 0 to pi. Okay, for the domain, principal domain 0 to pi. And these are the, and if you proceed this for other domains, the graph will be like this. Okay, so this part is nothing but the inverse part of the graph for the domain 0 to -π. Okay, and here this one is nothing but π to 2π. So likewise we can proceed the graph. This part is nothing but the part of the graph, inverse cosine graph, for the restricted domain, principal domain 0 to π. Okay, now look at the graph. This graph is not symmetric about origin, or it is not symmetric about y-axis. That is, the part to the left of y-axis and the right of y-axis are not similar, therefore it is not symmetric about y-axis. Also, if we rotate through 180 degree, it won't be the graph would not be the same. Therefore, it is not symmetric about origin. Therefore, hence we can conclude that this graph, that is the graph of inverse cosine function, is neither symmetric about y-axis nor symmetric about origin. Means it is neither an even function nor an odd function. Okay. So this is not symmetric to either origin or y-axis. Therefore, it is neither odd function nor even function. Now let us come to another small topic, small one, sinusoidal functions. So what do we mean by sinusoidal functions? Already I have explained in the previous video that sinusoidal function means if a graph is in this form, y is equal to, if the function is of the form y is equal to a sine bx or y is equal to a cos bx, then it is called a sinusoid. So this is a particular equation of the sinusoid, and the general form of a sinusoidal function is y is equal to a sine b into x minus c plus d, or y is equal to a cos b into x minus c plus d. Then what is the meaning for sinusoid? Means sinusoid is nothing but a curve. Okay, so a curve which describes a periodic oscillation. Periodic oscillation, that means which describes a wave-like wave-like pattern. That means a portion of the curve gets repeated again and again. That is a periodic oscillation. Then such curves are called a sinusoid. Usually sinusoid curves are obtained by either stretching or shifting or compressing the sine curve. So if the sine curve is either extended or compressed or shifted, then the resulting curve is called a sinusoid curve. Where we use the sinusoid curve means to describe any object which exhibits some periodic behavior. That is, just for example, we can say the heartbeat. To record the heartbeat, if the such graph, sinusoidal graphs are used. And then for a natural phenomena like measuring the tide, measuring the temperature at a place, we can use the sinusoidal functions. Okay, such sinusoidal graphs are used to exhibit that the periodic nature of that objects. And then here, this is the general form of the sinusoidal function, where this A is called the amplitude, and it is obtained by the formula maximum minus minimum value divided by 2. And this D is called the central line, y is equal to D. D is obtained? The average of the maximum value and the minimum value, that is maximum plus minimum divided by 2. And then what is the period of the sinusoidal curve is obtained? P is nothing but 2 times the time from the maximum to minimum. And then the value of B is obtained by 2 pi divided by P, or P is equal to 2 pi divided by P, whatever it may be. And then this C is called the horizontal shift, and it is obtained by the formula B into time at which the maximum value occurs. Okay. And then when if C is positive, this curve is shifted to right side, and when C is negative, the curve is shifted to left side. So this is the way to find out the given the values, we can find out the equation. Okay, so from the curve we can find the values of A, D, P, B and C, so that we can get the equation of the curve. Now let us see the examples. 4.5, find the principal value of cos inverse of root 3 by 2. Principal value means that should lies between the domain 0 to pi. Okay, so look at this value. What is the method to do this? Means if the value is positive, so the angle lies in the first quadrant. If it is negative, you have to choose the angle in the second quadrant, right? So here the value is positive, so you are going to get the principal value in the first quadrant. So let us take this one as y. By definition it will be cos y is equal to root 3 by 2. So for what value of y, its cosine value will be root 3 by 2. So for 30 degree only, we have cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So y is equal to pi by 6. Moreover, pi by 6 belongs to the closed interval 0 to pi. That is, pi by 6 lies in the first quadrant, no? Therefore, you can, this will be the principal value. So you have to take, write down the principal value to be pi by 6. That is, the required principal value is equal to pi by 6. Then example 4.6, find the cos inverse of minus 1 by root 2. So here look at the value, it is negative. Negative means you have to write the, find out the corresponding angle. There would be so many angles whose cos value will be minus 1 by root 2. But you have to choose the angle so that its cos value is minus 1 by root 2, and that angle should lie in the second quadrant as it is negative. Okay. So let us take this cos inverse of minus 1 by root 2 is equal to y. By definition it will be cos y is equal to minus 1 by root 2. So you have to find out the value angle whose cosine value is minus 1 by root 2, and that angle should lie in the second quadrant. Okay. Now how to find out that angle in the second quadrant whose value will be minus 1 by root 2? Now if you leave this minus, the value, let us take the positive value 1 by root 2. For what angle it will be, cos value will be plus 1 by root 2 for pi by 4. You know that cos pi by 4 is plus 1 by root 2. So let us take x to be that pi by 4. As the, it is negative, cos y is equal to minus 1 by root 2 here, the angle should lie in the second quadrant, that is pi minus x. So pi minus pi by 4, 3 pi by 4. So for 3, cos of 3 pi by 4 is equal to minus 1 by root 2. Okay. So this is the way to find out the angle in the second quadrant if it is negative. So what you have to do, take the positive value 1 by root 2. For what angle it will be, cosine value will be 1 by root 2 for pi by 4. Take it as x. As you have to find out the angle in the second quadrant, it would be pi minus x. So pi minus pi by 4, that is 3 pi by 4. Therefore, for 3 pi by 4, cos 3 pi by 4 will be equal to minus 1 by root 2. That means the principal value y is equal to 3 pi by 4. Clearly, 3 pi by 4 belongs to 0 to pi. Therefore, principal value is equal to 3 pi by 4. Okay. Now, second substitution is cos inverse of cos of minus pi by 3. Now you know that cos inverse of cos x is equal to x if x belongs to the principal domain 0 to pi, closed interval 0 to pi. But minus pi by 3 doesn't belongs to this interval 0 to pi. So you have to write it an angle equivalent to this value cos of minus pi. Again you have to write this another angle such that cos value and this cos value would be equal. Okay. So you have to find out an angle in this quadrant whose cos value will be equal to cos of minus pi by 3. Right. Now you know that cos of minus pi by 3 and cos pi by 3 will be same as cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. So cos of minus pi by 3 is equal to cos pi by 3. Now pi by 3 belongs to the closed interval 0 to pi. So we can apply this formula. So cos inverse of cos of pi by 3 is equal to pi by 3. Okay. Then third subdivision, cos inverse of cos 7 pi by 6. Now cos inverse of cos 7 pi by 6, again you know that 7 pi by 6 is not an angle in the first as well as in the second quadrant. So you have to express, you have to write down an angle equivalent to it such that the corresponding cos values would be equal, right? So how can you write this, split this 7 pi by 6? We can split this as pi plus pi by 6, okay? 7 pi by 6 can be split as pi plus pi by 6. Now cos of pi plus x and cos of pi minus x are equal. So we can express this because this angle lies in the third quadrant. Therefore,
cos of pi, we can rewrite it as cos of pi by minus x, that is pi minus pi by 6. So that the angle would come in the second quadrant, that is in our restricted domain 0 to pi. Now, for pi minus pi by 6 means it can be simplified as 5 pi by 6. So cos 7 pi by 6 and cos 5 pi by 6 are equal, right? And therefore, moreover, 5 pi by 6 belongs to the restricted domain 0 to pi. Therefore, cos inverse of cos 5 pi by 6 is equal to 5 pi by 6. Next example 4.7. Find the domain of cos inverse of 2 plus sin x divided by 3. Here you have to find out the domain of this function, right? For this inverse function. You know that the domain of general inverse cosine function is closed interval minus 1 comma 1. Therefore, the domain of this function also lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So, 2 plus sin x by 3 should lie between minus 1 to plus 1. So, in order to remove this 3, let us multiply 3 throughout. So, what happened? Minus 3 less than or equal to 2 plus sin x less than or equal to 3. Okay. Again, to remove this 2, let us subtract minus 2 throughout. So, on subtracting 2, you have minus 3 minus 2 minus 5 less than or equal to 2 plus sin x minus 2 means plus 2 and minus 2 get cancelled, sin x less than or equal to 3 minus 2, that is 1. So, even though it is minus 5 less than or equal to sin x less than or equal to 1, but you know that the range of sin is minus 1 to plus 1. That means this implies that sin value sin x lies between minus 1 to plus 1 because sin x doesn't go below minus 1. Therefore, this implies that minus 1 less than or equal to sin x less than or equal to 1. But you need the range of x. Therefore, let us take sin inverse throughout. So, sin inverse of minus 1 less than or equal to sin inverse of sin x is nothing but x and sin inverse of 1. Then, what is sin inverse of minus 1? Minus pi by 2. And then, sin inverse of 1 is pi by 2 because sin pi by 2 is 1 and the sin of minus pi by 2 is minus 1. Therefore, minus pi by 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi by 2. That means the range of x is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Even though, if you look at this, this is a sine function. Sine function means what would be its restricted domain minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So easily you can write down the domain as the closed interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Hope you have understood the inverse cosine function. Okay. So in the next video, we'll see the exercise problems. Thank you for watching.